My name is William Dukes, and this is the Den Life of an FAU football player. The bigger the field, the harder you fall. Saturday, I wake up early in the morning, 6 a.m., head to the cafeteria, get a good breakfast in before practice.
Tell a bad bitch, do whatever I say. My block behind me like I'm coming out the driveway.
When I leave the cafeteria, I go to the Osley Center, put on my equipment, go to the meeting room, eat my breakfast, and just chill there until my first meeting starts next specialty.
Come down, right? There's your guard, there's your offback, there's your tackle. Okay? You got four, three, and two.
After the special team meeting, the receivers race up to Coach Sam's room and the receiver room.
It's everybody going out to the field. It's going to be a little change a little bit.
Talk about what we're going to be doing that day, what we need to work on, and basically how practice is going that day, what new routes we got in, what new plays we need to learn, we need to know when we're going to the field.
If you can learn to be a great walkthrough team, you don't have to be full pad all the time. You can be helmets. You just come with the shoulder pads. But when you get to a walkthrough, you got to snap into mind, game mentality, great stance, and using my hands. I'm seeing the defense out there. Okay? Good stuff. Make it happen. Good morning.
Oh, you got a picture of Drew on the shirt.
Receiver love on three. One, two, three.
Receiver love.
Take shit in there,
get him, Duke. Get him, Duke.
Alright, you had a better day.
After the coach sends meeting, the receiving meeting, we go down to the locker room, put on our equipment, and head onto the field for a good walkthrough. Before the walkthrough, we work on our craft. That's like running sprints and working on getting off the ball and what receivers do. So after that, we do go into our walkthrough. After the walkthrough, we have our stretch. We stretch the whole team. The love of the green and the love of the team. Put together a circle that couldn't come in between. At the team period, we do like a circuit. It's basically drills with different coaches instead of your receiver coach or just you play. After we go through individual, we go to team period. Team period is a big competition against the defense. Defense, offense going at it at each other neck, trying to get the best of each other, trying to make us work hard. It's fun, but it's intense. After we do the team, Coach Pelini calls us up, talk about how the team period went, how we did, the offense, defense win, who got the best of each other.
What I want to see tomorrow, say mental preparation you had today, but I want to see a more physical practice. I want to see you guys getting after each other, putting pads on each other, tackling, locking up, O-line, getting on people. All right, I want to see a more physical practice. You guys with me?
Yes, sir.
I know, from watching tape on this team, we could be and should be the most physical team on the field. All right, but you got to approach this week with that. It's not just going to happen on Saturday, okay?
After he do all that, we say our prayer, we break, and because we have practice in the morning, our classes are set up to start at like 11:30. And so on after that, nothing before 10:30 because we got to practice. And walking through the breezeway can be a hassle because you know a lot of people on the breezeway, people want to stop and talk to you, give you handshakes, ask you how you're doing. But sometimes I just try to keep it moving because I have to get to class before class check. Color crime, major class. academic advisors, they'll set you up for tutoring, and you get 8 hours a week. The classes include in them 8 hours, so whatever you have left, the student advisors, they fill your schedule up with tutors and study hall. It might sound like it's boring or anything, but you get work done and you get good grades out of it. Started from the bottom, now we're here. After I'm done with my classes and my tutoring and study hall, sometimes there'd be a good activity on campus, like a basketball game, baseball game. And before the game, I'll probably just chill out with a couple of friends and head to the basketball game with them. We cheer on our basketball team or our baseball team, whatever activity it is. So after the basketball or baseball game, any activity you attend, everybody want to stay out there and talk to you and giggle around and play around. But as a student athlete, you have to realize that you have to be up the next day. So you want to go back to your room, freshen up, get on the phone and talk to whoever you want to talk to and let them know that you have to be up in the morning for practice, class, study hall, and whatever you want to do for the next day.